How to SSH and VNC to Raspberry Pi on Windows. First, you will need to download an SSH client. The most commonly used is called PuTTY, and can be downloaded from the link in the description below of this video. Look for PuTTY executable file for Windows on Intel x86. PuTTY doesn't have an installer package, it's just a .dot executable file. When you run PuTTY, you'll see the configuration screen. Type the IP address of the Pi into the hostname field and click the open button. If you eventually see a message saying network error, connection timed out, it's likely that you've entered the wrong IP address for the Pi. When the connection works, you'll see the security warning. Safely ignore it and click the yes button. And now you log in with the same username and password you would use on the Pi itself. The default login for Raspbian is Pi, and the password Raspberry. And then you should have the Raspberry Pi prompt. Now to connect over VNC using Windows, you'll need to download and install a VNC client program. First, you need to install the tight VNC package. On your Pi, using a monitor or over SSH, install the tight VNC package. Next, run tight VNC server, which will prompt you to enter a password, and an optional view-only password. Now start a VNC server from the terminal. This example starts a session on VNC, display 1 with full HD resolution. Now to connect over VNC, you'll need to download and install a VNC client program. A commonly used one is tight VNC, which can be downloaded from tightvnc.com. Depending on which version of Windows you are using, download the 32 or 64-bit download. During installation, and since you only need the VNC client and not the server, go ahead and choose custom. Then, select tight VNC server, and choose entire feature will be unavailable. Click next, and click next again, then install. Once the installation is complete, you should find tight VNC viewer under the start menu. When you run it, you'll be presented with this dialog. Now you will need to enter the IP address of the Raspberry Pi, followed by the screen number. Click connect and you'll be prompted for the password that was specified earlier. You should then find yourself at the Raspberry Pi desktop. Now if you forgot the VNC password you assigned earlier, use this command to reset and create new password. And again, thanks for watching. Subscribe and I see you in the next videos. Cheers. To buy a Pi starter kit, follow the links in description below to get more info.